Before we can run an analysis in IBM SPSS Statistics software, we must have data. We could, of course, type data directly into the SPSS data viewer. But many times, we will have data from some other source. Perhaps our data have been stored in Microsoft Excel, or perhaps our data are in some kind of text file, such as a CSV or TXT. We will cover all of those as we dive deeper into importing data into SPSS. This is demo.sav. The .sav suffix is the SPSS file format. I've heard it called .save or .sav. I just call it .sav. Call it whatever you want. Opening these native SPSS files is very easy. Just double-click. The data open in this window called the Data Editor. If you're working on other videos and are watching this one to find out how to open demo.sav, you can skip back now. If you want to know how to open Excel datasets or text files, then watch on. One of the most common ways that I receive data is from an Excel spreadsheet. Most people have a copy of Excel, and it's easy enough to use. Among the demo data sets that SPSS provides us is an Excel workbook. But before we open this file, I first want to look at it in Excel. Go to the Samples folder and select demo.xlsx. Double-click. First, we see that all of the data are on Sheet 1. That is good. Notice the structure of the data. The numbers are organized into rows and columns, and this is called rectangular data. We also see the variable names are in the first row as column headings. SPSS has specific rules about how it will handle variable names. If the names in your Excel spreadsheet do not conform to the SPSS variable name rules, then they will be converted to valid SPSS variable names. The original column headings will then be saved as variable labels. Now, there are some problems with this data. For instance, some of the string variables, like gender in this dataset, will have leading spaces. Because string variables are case sensitive, this will cause problems later. The leading space will be read as a different response than the same letter without the leading space. Another potential problem is the variable marital status. The 1 is married and the 0 is unmarried, but some of the values are displayed as no answer. If we leave the words in this variable, it will be read as a string variable, but we want it to be numeric. Let me show you how we will handle this in SPSS. Choose File, Import Data, Excel. We have been working in the Samples folder, so the window opens to there. Click on the Demo XLSX and click Open. We get this dialog box called Read Excel File. The dialog box asks whether we want to open Sheet 1 from our worksheet. If our Excel spreadsheet had multiple sheets, we could select the appropriate one from this drop-down list. We can only open one Excel worksheet for each SPSS dataset. Now here we see the option to read variable names from first row of data. We already have the variable names across the first row of our Excel spreadsheet. If you did not check this option, the first row would be read as actual data, and everything would be treated as string variables. Remember the problem that we had with string variables having leading spaces? We will check Remove Leading Spaces from String Variables. And just to be safe, we will remove trailing spaces as well. The string value will then be displayed in the cells that were system missing. In Excel, we saw that the marital status variable had some missing data displayed as no answer. Here, we see periods. Same problem. Neither option is numeric. If we import this as is, SPSS will make this a string variable. But we will fix this by checking percentage of values that determine data type. Now, as long as most of the values are numeric, SPSS will ignore the periods and treat the marital status variable as numeric rather than string. Click OK to read the Excel file. Our dataset now appears in the data editor. The column headings are now variable names. Because variable names cannot contain spaces, the spaces in the original column headings have been removed. For example, the column heading marital space status is converted to the variable marital status. Another common way that researchers exchange data is through a comma-delimited file called a CSV for comma-separated values. CSV files are great because everything opens CSV. It's a widely flexible format. Now, on the other hand, CSV does not allow you to store labels and variable settings like an SPSS file, so it means more work later on. To open the CSV, choose File, Import Data, CSV Data. The other problem with CSV that I should have mentioned is that there's not an example of a CSV dataset for our demo data, so there's nothing to open. No worries. This gives me the opportunity to show you another technique that works not only for CSV files, but other text files. This time, choose File, Import Data, Text Data. This time we see demo.txt, so that's good. But we also see text files that include text files, dat files, CSV, and tab delimited formats. So basically, it's hard to go wrong by using the text data import for any type of text file. Click on demo.txt and click Open. This will open the text import wizard. First, you can select a predefined format or create a new format in the wizard. Leave it set to No and click Continue. Select Delimited to indicate that the file has a delimited formatting structure. Select Yes to indicate that the file includes variable names at the top. The decimal symbol for our numbers is a period. The delimiter in this file is a tab. It is important that we know that, especially if we have commas in the numbers of our data instead of periods as decimals, or if we had extra spaces. So click Continue. Enter 2 for the line number where the first case of data begins, because the variable names are on the first row. Each line or row is a case. We want to import all cases. Therefore, these settings can be kept at their default. Click Continue. Here is where we really begin to see what our data are going to look like. You see that the default delimiters are tab and space. Now you may wonder what to do because I did not show you the original data set. But don't worry, just look at how the data are going to import. Unclick the tab delimiter. It got worse, didn't it? So re-click it. Click on comma. Nothing changed. So unclick it. Now notice all of these empty cells. Now under gender, we have M and F, but we also have an F over here and an M over here. This is a mess. But remember that we had some leading spaces with variables. Let's remove those leading spaces. Ah, that is much better. But look out here on the right. We still have more empty cells and words that do not match with numbers. What is happening here is that SPSS is still using spaces as a delimiter. So the space between the words income category is creating an extra column. To fix this, unclick space as a delimiter. feel free to click on other options and see what they do. Your goal here is to keep clicking until your data are rectangular and look correct. When they do, click Continue. We get a warning that SPSS has changed the invalid variable names, such as income category, and that's good. So click OK. In this next window, you can edit variable names, define data types, or make other changes. In the data preview, select income. Select dollar from the data format drop-down list. The variable marital status contains both string and numeric values. Fortunately for us, fewer than 5% of the values are words or periods. Leave the default setting of 95% for percentage of values that determine the automatic data format. This variable will be treated as numeric, and any string values will be set to system missing. If you change the default setting to 100, all of the original values will be preserved, but the variable will import as a string variable. Not what we want. So click Continue. Leave the default selections in the last step. Click Done to import the data. In the output window, you will find all of the syntax for what we have just done. You could include this with a copy of your original raw data to make your research more replicable. In other words, anyone else could run your syntax on your raw data and replicate exactly the same output that you did. You now know how to import data from the three common data types. Once you have imported your data, you're ready to add value labels, adjust column widths, deal with missing data, and get ready for analysis.